Blackstone Audio presents Pieces of My Mother, a Memoir by Melissa Cistaro. This book is read by Angela Brazil. For My Family, Past and Present. Author's Note: This story is a work of nonfiction and is drawn from memory, letters, early recollections of my childhood, and family lore. Some names and time sequences have been changed. The letters of my mother are written verbatim and at times condensed. Undoubtedly, there are things I've remembered differently than others, but this is the only version I know. This is my attempt to put the pieces back together. Then, a house underwater. Bun Bun notices my mom outside before I do. He tells me about it. We watch her walk toward her car. She's wearing her summer dress that is the color of ripe avocados. Her brown purse, slung over her shoulder, is as fat as the raccoon that crawls into our garbage cans late at night. And she has an armful of clothes hooked into her elbow. Her favorite coat drops onto the pavement. It doesn't look like a coat, the way it crumples up on the ground. I know that coat so well. Every bit of tan, brown, yellow, and red, every small wooden button. So many times I have traced the curling patterns and small rows of dots with my fingertip. And my mom always reminds me that the pattern is called paisley. She turns around, picks up her favorite paisley coat, and tosses it on top of the pile of clothes she's already put in the back seat of her blue car, then slams the car door shut. As she turns around to look back at the house, I have Bun Bun do a little wave and a dance as I duck below the window in my room. She'll think Bun Bun has really come to life. His tan head and floppy ears are made of real rabbit fur that only recently began to shed around his green eyes and on the tips of his ears. I know how to make him look like he's hopping through a field. I lift my eyes just above the ledge. My mom is standing next to the car, looking down at her feet. I am supposed to be taking a nap, but it's too hot, and I don't like to sleep. During nap time, my whole room comes to life, and anything can happen. Stuffed animals talk to each other, fairies fly out of the wall sockets, and plastic horses gallop across the hardwood floor. My brother told me that when I'm 5, like him, I won't have to stay in my room during nap time. For days now, the air has been like fire, so hot that it ripples above the concrete and makes things outside look like they're underwater. It is the kind of heat that has made our next-door neighbor's dogs hide underneath our house where it's cool and dusty. Mr. Bird, who owns the dogs, came over and told us this just yesterday. "Dogs know what to do with themselves when California heats up like this. But not people," he said. "It's the kind of heat that could cause some folks to snap." And when he said that word, snap, he took the toothpick out of his teeth and broke it in two. Then he laughed like he thought he was clever. Later, I saw his broken toothpick on our porch and kicked it into the dead grass where it got lost in all the yellow. I opened my bedroom door and peer into the living room. My brother Eden is asleep on the couch with a box of Lucky Charms wedged underneath his arm. The TV is on, and I watch for a moment as Underdog flies across the gray screen, and I remember that my brother Jamie isn't here. He's almost 6, and the oldest. He left the house earlier to go swimming in his friend Bobby Winston's pool. My mom was mad when Mrs. Winston showed up early to grab Jamie for swimming. She told Mrs. Winston that she only had 2 cigarettes left and didn't want to go out to the store in the heat. When Mom is out of cigarettes, she counts on Jamie to be here with Eden and me so she can run down to the corner market. If she has to wait too long to get them, the house begins to swell with noise, the clap of cupboards opening and closing.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.